CNN, the most trusted name in news.
Two more attorneys are saying no thanks to offers from President Trump to join his legal team to help defend him in the ongoing Russia investigation. Both of the attorneys, Dan Webb and Tom Buchanan, are part of the high-powered Chicago firm Winston & Strawn. This makes the fifth major law firm we know of to receive an invitation to work in the president's defense. White House Press Secretary Sarah Sanders spoke about that today.
The president in the last few weeks has reached out to a number of high-profile lawyers to take him on as a client in the Russia probe. Dan Webb took a pass recently. Ted Olson took a pass recently. Others have as well. I'm wondering why the president has had so much trouble finding an experienced lawyer willing to take him on, and who at this hour is his lead counsel in negotiating with Robert Mueller and the special counsel?
Look, the president has a highly qualified team with several individuals that have been part of this process, Ty Cobb, Jay Sekulow. For specific details on any search process outside of the White House, I would refer you to his outside counsel.
His lead counsel now.
I would refer you to outside of the White House, I would refer you to Jay Sekulow, who can address any detailed questions on that front.
As for the president, as we mentioned earlier, he's been relatively quiet on the Twitter front lately, but on Sunday he tweeted, "Many lawyers in top firms want to represent me in the Russia case. Don't believe the fake news narrative that it's hard to find a lawyer who wants to take this on. Fame and fortune will never be turned down by a lawyer, though some are conflicted. Problem is that a new lawyer or law firm will take months to get up to speed, if for no other reason than they can bill more, which is unfair to our great country, and I'm very happy with my existing team. Besides, there was no collusion with Russia except by Crooked Hillary and the Dems." I'm joined now by a legal mind who knows a lot about Washington investigations, John Dean, former Nixon White House counsel and a CNN contributor. Also with us, CNN legal and national security analyst Asha Rangappa. John, how do you reconcile the president's claims that many big-time lawyers want to represent him with the reality that none seem to be coming on board at this time? And how perilous is that for the president?
Well, I don't think there is an easy way to reconcile it, because Trump is just way off base. I think there are a couple problems. There probably are some legitimate conflicts with firms in Washington, but there's also another problem, and that's the reputation the potential client has. He's a difficult client. He doesn't follow the advice of his attorneys, and he also doesn't pay. And I think that last item might be a dominant item.
I mean, Asha, is there any reason to believe that Robert Mueller would delay his desire to speak to President Trump if the president doesn't have a team in place?
I don't think so. I mean,
he has Jay Sekulow.
Exactly. If he has an attorney there, Mueller is going to move forward with his plan. I mean, he's been very efficient so far. And you know, one thing to keep in mind is that Mueller has an excellent legal team. These are lawyers who went to the best law schools, who are prosecutors, Supreme Court clerks. And this is a complicated federal investigation. It involves all kinds of criminal law, and it's going to test the bounds of the Constitution, just given who Trump is. So Trump is going to need to get not just an experienced attorney, but also a legal scholar. And if he doesn't get somebody who is top-notch on both of those fronts, he's going to get crushed.
Do you buy the argument, I guess, that some firms are saying that they have a conflict? I mean, big firms represent many different people. Is it true that, you know, they can't represent, if it's a huge firm and it's different attorneys and there's separation between them, they can't represent Trump and somebody else who's involved in the investigation?
As John said, there may be conflicts, but you know, Anderson, this is the kind of job that most lawyers have normally dreamed of. It makes a legal career. And the fact that you have a challenging case or even an unpopular client is actually kind of a badge of honor. John Adams represented the British soldiers in the Boston Massacre. But as John said, he's a bad client. He doesn't treat his lawyers particularly well. He may not pay him. And let's remember that we're sitting on the edge of our seat every single day wondering if Trump is going to fire Mueller. I don't think you want to be his attorney if and when that happens, because newsflash, the investigation will go on, and then as the attorney, you might get sucked into the vortex also and become questioned by Mueller, and no attorney wants to go down that road.
John, I mean, we always make the caveat that we want to be careful with any Watergate comparisons, but President Nixon's personal lawyers, as I understand, he wasn't even agreeing to meet with them at certain points, much less take their advice. So the notion of a president who trusts his own instincts more than anyone else, does that ring familiar to you?
It does very much so. In fact, what happened with Nixon is he refused until really after he left office to get a highly competent criminal lawyer, notwithstanding advice to the contrary from yours truly, that he needed somebody early. And so he delayed it and never really did have good counsel. You asked the question if Mueller would go forward if he didn't have good counsel. Well, the Watergate special prosecutor knew they did not have good representation. I've asked these guys over the years, was there any lawyer Nixon ever had while he was in office that gave you any concern that he was going to be a tough cookie to deal with? And they said, absolutely none. They were, in fact, surprised at how weak the legal representation was.
So what did Nixon say to you when you were advising him early on that he needed to get attorneys?
Didn't want to hear it. Did not want to hear it.
It is sort
and
of...
did not bring anybody in with that experience.
It is, John, I mean, baffling that there is no iconic Washington defense attorney eager to take on Mueller on behalf of the president of the United States. I mean, it's not a town short on attorneys.
I think it's one of the real issues for some of the firms is that they won't get paid. That's the rumbling I've been picking up and talking to Washington lawyers I know. But I think he'll probably find somebody in Washington who'll step forward. He's got the word out there now. So I think some Republican lawyer probably will come forward.
John Dean, Asha Rangappa, thanks very much. Coming up, first, his parents sued. Now the brother of Seth Rich also.